Testament. There it is used to speak of an even more dramatic change. Ordinary people like you and me, people who were sinners by nature and by action, can be transformed, metamorphosed into a likeness of Jesus. That is the hope of every follower of Jesus, that we will increasingly take on a change in our behavior, attitude, and character and become more like Jesus Christ. Some may ask, but how does a dramatic transformation take place? It is something that God simply brings about in your life by his power, or is it something you do through your own will? The answer to that question is found in our key verse, chapter 5, verse 17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creature. The old has gone, the new has come. Christ transforms us. In this section of 2 Corinthians, Paul gives us the tools we need to be metamorphosed. The first change that we receive is a new nature. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he or she is a new creation. The old has gone, the new has come. Anyone who belongs to Christ is a new person. Because Christ lives in us and his love controls us. Christians are new people. Just like the butterfly, we get rid of our old shell and become a new creation. At our conversion, we were born again and are not the same anymore. The Bible teaches us that Christians are not merely reformed, rehabilitated, or re-educated. We are recreated. God gives to every person who becomes a Christian a new nature, the Spirit of Christ. We are not merely turning over a new leaf. We are beginning a new life under a new master. Paul is saying that every Christian is a new creation in Christ, and they no longer live for themselves, but for Jesus who died and rose for each and every one of us. When we become like a caterpillar and we turn into a butterfly, we receive a new beginning. If anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. It is January, and a couple of weeks ago, many people made resolutions to do better or be better. How many of you kept them? I don't know. The butterfly is the new beginning of the caterpillar, and as followers of Jesus Christ, we have to do more than make a resolution. It is embracing a new life. It is starting out on a new beginning. The Apostle Paul, who wrote this book, himself was a living testimony of a new beginning. Before his conversion, his name was Saul, and he was full of educated hate. In Acts chapter 8 and 9, he was a religious extremist who sought to arrest and kill all Christians. But one day on the road to Damascus, he was blinded by the light of God. When you're blind or inside the cocoon, it's dark, you can't see. So Paul was on his cocoon because he was dark on the inside. He was blinded by the light of God. But after his conversion, love was his controlling motive. For Christ's love compels us. We are ruled by Christ's love for us. When we become followers of Christ, we are often transformed in dark places. We must learn to grow and become better out of our dark places and not stay there. We can't live in self-pity of the past or become victims of our circumstances because we are more than conquerors. Through Jesus Christ, we are rewriting our stories one day at a time. The next chapter of our lives will always be different than the last chapter, but it's a continuation of it. We must put away the old things, old habits, and old people, and strive for the mark of the high calling. After we understand our new beginning, we must know that we have a new purpose, which will be found in verses 18 through 20. All of this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. That God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, not counting man's sins against them. And he has committed to us the message of reconciliation. We are therefore Christ's ambassadors. As though God were making his appeal through us, we implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. God made him who had no sin for us come in the form of life and be sinful, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. Paul is saying that God has a new purpose for every Christian. All Christians are to be reconcilers. Some may ask, what are reconcilers, or what is the word reconciliation? Reconciliation is a change for the better in a relationship between two or more people. Just like when you're married, you have to reconcile with your wife. Most times with men, you're not a reconciler, because women have that way. Amen? Amen. This, of course, is the message of the Bible in verse 18. That all this is from God. who reconciled himself through Christ. Because the church is what? Christ's bride, God's bride. Amen. We are to help bring others into relationship with God. Our old lives can be used in our new purpose. We must show others that all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. We can show that Jesus came to change us and make us new. The message of this book is that God has not turned his back on us. That is why Jesus came into the world and why he died on the cross. He died on the cross so that a transaction could take place. He was rejected that we might be accepted. He was condemned that we might be forgiven. He was punished that we might be pardoned. He was hated that we might be loved. He was crucified that we might be justified. He died that we might live. Because when he rose, he conquered sin, death, and the grave. He did that that we might be found blameless, know his love, be saved, and help save others. Our new purpose is to love you one another, because love covers a multitude of sin. As our theme in scripture stated, we must be reconciled to God. We all have asked, can we be reconciled to God, which only means we can be put into a new relationship with him. The evidence that we are Christians is that we have received a new life, is that we have a new purpose, and that we have reconciled others to God. That is what God calls us to do. You and I have received life from the Lord Jesus Christ. Now it is our privilege and our calling to lead others to that same life. We must fly like the butterfly so that others can follow. At this time, I'm going to ask everyone to close your eyes. And as we meditate on the selection, I'm going to give us a challenge for this week. This is technically our invitation, but we're going to do it a little bit different today. day of salvation.
Sing over us, God.
His love is available to each and every one of us.
Message.